and so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
You know, Michael Beasley basically was given away by the Miami Heat for a second-round pick and some cap space. Pretty surprising. Former number two overall pick. He's an outstanding scorer.
He misses the free throw. Clark, you're talking about Michael Beasley. The Heat traded him away so they could create space to sign Mike Miller. Steve, do you think they'll come to regret that decision?
No, I think Miami is perfectly happy with where they are going into the future. You know, remember, they traded him away to create more cap space, and that was one of the reasons they were able to get LeBron and Chris Bosh. So who knew what was going to eventually become of him? He had a great season with Minnesota, so it looks like he's going to be a very productive player during his career.
Here's Dunleavy, feeds to Delfino. Here's Dunleavy. He's guarded by Ridnow. Outside, Delfino. And that one's good. Delfino's got 7 points in the game.
Fellas, they are heating up from outside now.
Yep. Of their last 5 hoops, 3 of them have come from long range.
Now here's Beasley. And he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick. Beasley's got his 2nd bucket of the game to go. Bucks leading by 13. Unload from 9. Second shot opportunity, and he races to the bucket for 2. And the Bucks lead by 15.
Oh, that's a nice job on the boards to allow them a second high-quality look.
It's Beasley on the wing. Easy shot. He squares up and sinks it. 6 points for him.
Boy, I like the fluidity I'm seeing from them on offense. It's a thing of beauty. Fun to watch.
Yeah, it is. They're moving the ball well, finding the open man, making that extra pass. They're playing very unselfishly right now.
Outside, Delfino. And again, Milwaukee with the triple.
Carlos.
Boy, he's really starting to get in the flow now. A nice groove. That's his 2nd here in the quarter, after none in the 1st.
And Pekovic backs down. The jump hook. The rebound by Gooden. Gooden's got his 4th rebound in this one.
And this is why they have the big lead. The rebounding has been dominant.
You know, guys, the +8 rebounding, I don't think it tells the whole story. I mean, they've been the more physical team from the outset. That's been the difference, their physicality.
Here's Beasley. The 2nd effort, and it's blocked. Bucks leading by 16. Here's Hudrick. Dishes it to Dunleavy. Covered by Rubio. Yep, it's good.
Mike Dunleavy.
Dunleavy's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And I think defensively, you've got to commit a 2nd defender because he's just destroying you right now.
Yeah, one-on-1, he's been a handful.
And the Timberwolves call timing.
You know, the story with Milwaukee last year was a team that just struggled to score the ball, Kevin. I mean, nobody was able to consistently put it in the basket for him.
Williams, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. Johnson comes in for Michael Beasley. and then for Milwaukee. Ilyasova, he's checked in for Mbamute. Ellis comes in for Mike Dunleavy, and it's Jennings in for Udrich. Here's Williams. Ilyasova on him. Tries in the post. Williams can't get it to go. And the Bucks with possession. They're on a 14-6 run. Here's Delfino. He's guarded by Johnson. Ilyasova passes to Delfino. The feed to Gooden. He's against Williams. Shot by Gooden is no good. Timberwolves trail by 18. Rubio dishes to Ridenour. Picked up by Ellis. An easy 2 points on the layup. Rubio's got 10.
They can't seem to stop anybody inside.
They got to know that if they don't make life tougher in the paint, the opponent is just going to keep going there. I mean, it's not like they'll get tired of all these in-close opportunities.
Now here's Jennings. He's got 6. Pass to Ellis. The shot's good. Jennings making the play. 10 points for Ellis. Here is Rubio. 10 points for him. Guys, this offense very effective.
Going right at him.
And this is where you just start picking apart the defense, and now you take their confidence away. You can really take control of this game.
Let's check out what Doris Burke has for us.
Well, Kevin, after 2 years of playing overseas, the Minnesota Timberwolves finally get Ricky Rubio to come over from Spain. You'll remember this young man burst onto the scene in the Olympics when he was outstanding against the United States. The general manager, David Kahn, was very high on him after drafting him in 2009, saying of him, a virtuoso and somebody special. He has a lot of hype to live up to after 2 years of waiting, guys. We'll see if he can fulfill that potential. Back to you.
Thank you, Doris. So much has been said about Rubio. He's got to be feeling the pressure.
You know, it might take some time for him to adjust, but I remember seeing him play for Spain in 2008, and I think he can play at this level.
At the line for the Bucks, Carlos Delfino. 2 shots.
That's good from Delfino.
Now, the Bucks had all kinds of problems last year, and they really didn't do a good job against the Western Conference. In fact, they failed to even reach double-digit wins against Western Conference opponents.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Back to that point Steve was making with the Bucks in the West, Clark, Western teams have no problem scoring.
Well, it starts with, one, the talent that's out in the Western Conference across the board, and then style of play. The Bucks, on the other hand, had all sorts of problems putting up points, and it just made for a bad combination. Playing and trying to beat the West and not being able to score, that's a recipe for not being successful.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way it's been. A big margin for them in the rebounding category.
You know, sometimes you got to get down and dirty and do the dirty work. And in this one, they've done it, and it's paid off on the scoreboard in a big way.
Here's Ellis. He feeds it to Delfino. He kicks to Gooden. The second chance effort. And it's blocked. Kicks it out to Jennings. He's guarded by Johnson. Johnson against Jennings. He dishes it to Ellis. Delfino with the three. Rebounded by the Timberwolves.
A few things you know you're going to get with a Scott Skiles coach team. Tough defense, tough-mindedness, fundamentals are going to be demanded. That was a formula to work for the Bucks in their playoff run in 2010, but they need to find some offense now.
Now here's Williams. Off target there with the little leaner.
He operates pretty well in traffic, guys, but that was a tough play to finish off.
Ellis. Williams pulls it in. Back to Skiles. Unfortunately, last year they were just okay in those areas. But, Steve, they just had a horrible offense.
They were very good defensively, Kevin, but they just could not score. And I think that's the big challenge this year for the Bucks if they're going to get back into the playoffs. They've got to find a way to get easy baskets offensively.
Timeout called, the Bucks. Minnesota. Kevin Love's checked in for Pekovic. Beasley comes in for Williams. And Barea subbed in for Luke Ridnour. And the Bucks making a change here as well. Larry Sanders is checked in for Drew Gooden. Here's Jennings. 6 points for him. Here's Sanders. Goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
That was his rebound all the way, no doubt about it.
And Clark, once he got it, he knew exactly what to do with it.
Yep, take it up strong and throw it down hard.
Swiped it away. And here they come. The dish to Ellis from about 19 feet, and he nails the jumper. Delfino's got 10 points now just in this quarter. The Timberwolves really have a tough one to go here. And Love backs in. Puts it up. Hits the jump hook. Love's got 9.
Well, they're not shooting as many from outside here in the second quarter.
Well, they were shooting well early on. I like their spacing and their offensive flow. I think they need to get back to that.
Now here's Jennings. Ellis, left side. Jennings kicks to Delfino. The three. Kicks it out to Jennings. Off target from three-point range. Here's Rubio. Oh, he put it down!
It'll count.
What a shot!
I think that one was good.
At the buzzer!
Rubio. The fans are loving it, Kevin. What a shot!
So as we conclude the first half, so far fairly one-sided. And we'll get it going after this from the Target Center.
And welcome, everybody, to HP at the Half, and we got a wild one going on out at Target Center. The Milwaukee Bucks have the lead against Minnesota. It's been a gritty defensive effort with some emphatic rejections on the highlight reel. Monte Ellis dialed in against the Timberwolves. He's got 10 points. He's been dynamic on both ends of the court, finding teammates, playing tough D on the other end. Not the same story, though, for the Timberwolves. They've done a lackluster job boxing out for the defensive rebounds, getting run over inside. The first half, a letdown for Derek Williams. His shooting woes have been well documented, and the camera crew is in here shooting it again tonight. Some great play out of these two in today's action so far. They'll look to carry on that play into the second half. Thanks so much for joining us here in the studio. We hope to see you next time. We'll send you back out to the second half.
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the third and fourth quarters. Here's Ellis. Here's who Scott Skiles is starting the second half with. Jennings out.